They say all that glitters is gold. But if you ask me, all that glitters on the fashion ramp has to be the BMW India Bridal Fashion Week 2014 in association with ASVA. We've seen stunning bridal couture, we've seen designers trying to experiment, and we've also seen a whole lot of Bollywood glamour. It's been a great journey so far, and we've had a lot of designer action. Here's a look back at some of the fun from the last few days.
The Helyani's modern Mughal's trousseau was beautifully traditional with an edge of sophistication, while Ashima and Lina's collection was inspired by the magical Arabian Nights. This year, Raghuvendra Rathore brought out some designer relics from the royal wardrobe, and his bridal collection truly stood out. And at the center of it all was the superior design and craftsmanship of BMW and the gorgeous jewelry by ASVA.
It's time now for the couture collection by Falguni and Shane Peacock, one of the very cool and eclectic designer duos who've made a mark with their unique style, and needless to say, they have a big fan following across the country. The show's just about to begin, so let's go and see what surprises they have in store for us this time around.
It's a Falguni and Shane Peacock show, then it's fair to say that the audience can expect only the unexpected. Darkness descends on the audience and the spotlight is on the bridal collection. The designer's Nui Sauvage or Wild Night collection vibrates with sensual, electrifying energy. It's a masquerade unlike any seen on the ramp and adds a wild element to the traditionally reserved bridal wear. Heavily embroidered lehengas are teamed with jackets and gowns shimmer, sachet and dazzle. Sheer capes add to the elegant silhouette of the gowns and heavily embroidered biker jackets show off lehengas. Ensemblers in off-white, pink and peach are accentuated with gold, silver and sparkling crystal. Elaborate and exquisite, vintage thread work and digital prints are the highlight of this collection. Whether it is the long flowing gowns or the quirky lehenga choli with a heart-shaped neckline, this is a trousseau for the bride who likes the unusual. Rich contrast to the subtle palette are the deep reds, maroons and the designer's signature color black. that add a dash of drama. A traditional red and gold lehenga is teamed with a sheer jersey. Now this is something truly apt for the bride with an edge. Whether she's conventional or walks on the wild side, this wedding season, Falguni and Shane Peacock have something truly spectacular for the futuristic bride. When the designers take center stage, it is clear that the show is a wild success. Falguni and Shane Peacock have just finished another smashing show. Let's have a word with them. Charu, you were their showstopper. Tell me first of all about the outfit that you're wearing.
Well, as you can see, it's spectacular. And Shane and Falguni always create beautiful clothes. And I was really honored when they asked me to walk for them. So I'm very happy to look beautiful. They made me look very, very beautiful tonight. Yeah.
So there are a lot of fashion shows and fashion weeks happening in India now. You must be attending a whole lot of them. How do you think the India Bridal Fashion Week stands out?
Well, I think it's firstly very important that it showcases a talent specifically for brides. Yeah. And a lot of the designers then showcase very interesting pieces and they take it, and there's a bit of creativity on what a bridal outfit should be. So it's also a good expression for that as well, and it opens up the entire genre of bridal. You know, it's not just a lehenga, choli and a veil, it's something as beautiful like this that you can wear to a cocktail or to a reception, and so it's very important.
So now we've seen a lot of combining digital prints, like in this collection of yours, with a beautiful hand embroideries and these embellishments. What was the thought behind that?
It's just that every season we do, embroidered clothes, embellished. And we had decided that this time we'd do something really outrageously different than what we'd been doing. So we thought of doing digital printed skirts and having cholis with it and doing jackets, biker jackets, which is our look, the rock and roll look. We can't just forget that. So it has to, that touch has to be there in our clothes. So we tried to stay close to what we do otherwise, you know.
So, and for this collection specifically, what was your inspiration, or what was that starting point that, okay, this collection is going to look like that?
This time we decided that we'd do, you know, every time we do more sort of subtle embellishments, and, you know, we wanted to do tone on tone, more sort of goals, and give it a Victorian edge. And I guess we managed to do it pretty well.
I'm going to get you to talk now. You have to give our brides who are going to get married this year some tips for the trend for this bridal season 2014.
I think they're very selective about the brides. When a bride wants to buy, they know who they're going to buy, you know, and they know exactly what they want.
Yeah.
You know, if they want a certain style, they go to that designer. And that the brides that come to us, they're more young, they're more willing to experiment.
Correct.
They're willing to take it to another edge, like wear a gilet jacket with a skirt or something like that.
So you when know? He says young, he means first time brides, huh? You've got to be clear about that.
By the way, when we had all our campaigns, we had many times.
Yeah.
Many times.
Yeah.
So parting question then, from a designer point of view, how does a platform like BMW India Bridal Fashion Week help you? How does it work?
I guess, I mean, this is a very different thing what they've tried, and having it in Emporio, it's such a great experience coming, having a look at a show and then going back, shopping and coming back. So I just think that this is something which is really there to stay. This Fashion Week is there to stay.
So great. Yeah. Congratulations on a fabulous show once again, and thanks for chatting with us.
Don't go anywhere, for up next is Suneet Varma's eagerly awaited bridal collection for BMW India Bridal Fashion Week.
Welcome back. He's experienced, style, poise, glamour, and a whole lot of success all rolled into one.
That's right, I'm talking about Suneet Varma, who's very well known for his bridal collection. But I've got a little birdie telling me that Suneet is trying to veer away from what he usually does and give his viewers something absolutely new. So I'm going to head out and check out the buzz about his upcoming show.
The hand-painted Rajasthani town of Shekhawati, with its incredible collection of frescoes, is the inspiration of Suneet Varma's collection for the BMW India Bridal Fashion Week. The stage, with its intricate miniature paintings, life-size elephants and peacock motif, is a fitting tribute to the collection that captures the very essence of Shekhawati art. The bridal trousseau is designed to meet the taste of every discerning bride. The intricately embellished ghagras and saris are matched with spectacular blouses and cholis. And the necklines and intricate mirror work deserve special mention. Headgear, hairpins and earrings make every model look like a princess. The jewelry is painstakingly and intricately handcrafted using age-old Shekhawati techniques. Suneet Varma has chosen to work with for the Princess of Shekhawati collection gives every bride something truly spectacular to take home. Muted gold and cream create a splendid background for the fine Ari embroidery in the same tone. Magically transforms traditional Shekhawati paintings and architecture into delicate and fine embroidery that liberally grace Farsi pajamas, heavy lehengas, sheer ornis and saris. The collection generously uses fabrics such as crushed velvet and soft chiffon that drape well and create a wonderful background for the embroidery.
The deep reds and pretty pinks are celebratory, and the exquisite embroidery reflects every nuance of the Shekhawati art, which interestingly enough also has a European touch. Layered lehengas with cholis that featured a sweetheart neckline make the bride look regal and feminine. She is spoiled for choice with the wide range of colors and shades that Shekhawati collection offers her. Finally, time for the showstopper, and the audience awaits in complete silence. Kangana Ranaut walks for Suneet Verma, looking resplendent in a maroon bustier with a red ghagra. The choker on her neck is breathtaking, and the peacock colors add a bit of spring to the ensemble.
When we return, we'll have a chat with Suneet and his gorgeous showstopper Kangana Ranaut.
We had all the girls in the mirror work, and then we had the thread embroidery, and then the beautiful zardozi.
Absolutely love. The mirror work was like outstanding.
We're back with the BMW India Bridal Fashion Week, where Suneet Verma's showstopper is the talk of the town.
Congratulations, Suneet. As promised, you've delivered something completely new. How excited are you?
Well, very excited that we actually got to be part of the BMW India Bridal Couture Week. And, you know, it's the first time that BMW has taken it. And so when I said to you, like I said to you yesterday, when an international brand like Azwa and BMW back Indian couture, there's two things. A, we've come of age for Indian couture. And B, you know, bridal wear is a very serious aspect of the Indian fashion designers business, so it's a great opportunity, and it's only going to grow. What do you think, Frank?
Exactly. Yes.
So Kangana, you're a very close friend of Suneet's. How does it feel to be walking in Delhi on the ramp for his show?
It feels great, and I'm very impressed with Suneet. This particular show, I think he's outdone himself, and it's so refreshing. And I mean, I saw some of the designs, and I was like, why can't I sit in the audience? Why can't I see everything?
So tell me about the frieze that you're wearing. You absolutely love it. You look stunning.
But he will tell you about
the inspiration
it.
Is Shekhawati. We were discussing that earlier, from Rajasthan. Therefore, you see this brilliant set. And of course, the elephant motif. And of course, the peacock motif is a recurring motif in all the architecture. Yes, is also the recurring motif in all the architecture of Shekhawati, which is the only hand-painted city in the world. The entire city was hand-painted. And therefore, this inspiration, the hand-painted elephant. And I think Kangana sort of brings a certain element of Indianness that's modern and contemporary for a bride as well. And so we showed all our traditional brides, but I also want to
evoke a new response in terms of what Kangna would bring to the ramp as a modern Indian bride. And I think when BMW comes to the table, everybody has to work much harder to be able to actually not just... Yes, everybody has to work much harder to put their best foot forward. So hopefully we delivered.
So Frank, we've seen BMW really combining with the Indian bridal couture at a beautiful level. It's all blending in very beautifully. What do you have to say about Suneet's show?
It was absolutely breathtaking today. You know, all this craftsmanship and this time and effort that Suneet and his team has to put into it, it's really amazing. And I think bridal fashion is probably amongst the best that India has to offer. It's absolutely world-class level. And we are happy to associate our brand, which share the same kind of values, you know, about engineering, precision, perfection, etc. So it's a natural fit.
Yes, I think so too.
I think so too. And Suneet, like you said, you want to up the level of production value in each show. You had some beautiful aerial performances in this particular show. What was the inspiration behind all of that?
Well, you know, I think that nothing works better than sensuality. You know, I mean, it's very important. It's the heart of everything that one should do. Because if you don't feel the sensualness of yourself, of your clothing, of the audience, if you don't titillate it. And so I actually wanted to show the most beautiful Indian animal, the elephant. And I want this woman to command it. And I wanted to make love to it. And I wanted to sort of caress the elephant at the same time.
So therefore, embroidery as well.
So that was sort of the beginning of the show. And then, of course, we had all the girls in the mirror work. And then we had the thread embroidery and then the beautiful Zardozi.
Absolutely. Love the mirror work was like outstanding, and I don't know if that's just you who's doing it with so much of, you know, detailing, but I haven't seen something like that in
no, I think this season we've kind of taken it to another level and tried to reinvent it
and
in the color.
Completely different from your usual style.
It's
you've
very
really
well. I hopefully I've sort of done something new and interesting. I don't know about outdone, but you're very kind though. Thank you very much. Thank
so
you.
I was just going to ask you then, Kangna, and I think you've already answered that. Your personal favorite from this entire collection.
I think the mirror work, because I like his delicate take on Indian wedding, because they, you know, the clothes can get very loud, but he uses pastel colors, and he uses very unusual colors, and I think, but the mirror work this time just took all my attention.
Thank you so much for chatting with us. Congratulations on a beautiful show.
The 4-day of the BMW India Bridal Fashion Week draws to a close, and the audience leave appropriately impressed and quite starstruck.
It's a phenomenal show. The collection was very well done. And in one show, we could see a lot of different kinds of craftsmanship with a lot of intricate work. So it's just really amazing.
Wonderful. I think this is classical Indian fashion, and we like it very much. Very impressive.
Very nice. Very nice colors. Impressive.
There's a lot of hard work that goes into making every collection a complete success. Even as we speak, thousands of karigars are already working on the designers' next collections. But hey, as long as we keep getting couture like this, I'm not one to complain. We're going to have a lot more beautiful bridal couture tomorrow, so remember to stay tuned. That's it for tonight. Good night.